Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Today we are going to start with the second part from the motor system, that is the brainstem. Last time we talked about the spinal cord, so we are going up from the spinal cord to the brainstem. Our aims here is to describe the general function of the brainstem. Besides its motor function, there are other functions. Like in the brainstem, we have, as you have in the first semester, the cardiac centers and the respiratory centers. These are the vital centers. As you have also already taken in GI tract, you have the vomiting center, salivary center, sneezing center. All these centers, non-vital centers, they are found in the brainstem. We will like to talk about the descending tracts that originate from the brainstem. You know, these tracts, when we talked about the spinal cord, we said that these motor tracts pass in the spinal cord. Some of them, they originate in the brainstem from the reticular formation, from the vestibular nuclei, from the red nucleus. Explain how these tracts work to control motor movement. Outline some brainstem abnormalities. Here the general sketch for motor pathways. You remember that last time we talked about the motor command here. We said that the motor command starts from brain motor cortex, corticospinal, the spinal cord. Also here, the motor command might start from the brain stem centers to the spinal cord. It might come from the red nucleus to the spinal cord. These are the motor commands. You know these arrows, the feedback. Last time we talked about feedback when we talked about the tracks that come from the receptors here, the receptors in the muscle. You remember the receptor in the muscle is the muscle spindle and the Golgi tendon organ. These are, they give feedback to the spine cerebellum, it's called spinal cerebellum. That comes from dorsal and ventral spinal cerebellar tract. You know about the motor command here, the motor command to command the monitor. That the command that comes from the cortex through the corticospinal, they go through brainstem areas here. The one like corticobontocerebellar, corticoreticulocerebellar, corticoolivary. Remember inferior olive. Don't mix it with the superior olive. You may remember superior olive, the auditory system. Inferior olive here, the motor tract. Okay. Okay. So this is the general. Let's see what is in from the stem before we come to that. The brainstem, as you know, is an extension of the spinal cord. So anything that passes from down up or up down to the spinal cord or from the spinal cord has to pass through the spinal cord. So the spinal cord has to pass through the brainstem, I mean. So the brainstem really is a pathway also for descending and ascending tract. A damage might occur in the brainstem area and cause the same defects that the damage might occur in the spinal cord. So it depends. The brainstem performs motor and sensory function. You know, from the ascending and descending tract, cranial nerve that come from the brainstem and they are sensory to the head and face. This is a trigeminal cranial nerve number 5. You remember when we talked about the sensory tracts from the face and head through the trigeminothalamic tract. And trigeminothalamic tract transmits all the sensation that is either coming from the dorsal column, where you find touch, fine pressure, blah, 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 or the one that comes through the lateral and anterior lateral spinothalamic pain. Temperature besides crude touch, crude pressure, itching, and scratch. Similar to spinal cord, function from head down also. Contains centers that for stereotypic movements, stereotypic movements and equilibrium, especially the tracts that come from the articular formation and the vestibular nuclei. You know, the vestibular nuclei send tracts that's called vestibulospinal. You remember vestibulospinals, articulospinals, they are concerned with extensors, okay? The muscle of the spinal column and the extensor muscles of the legs support the body against gravity. These are called anti-gravity muscle, against gravity. These muscles are controlled really by brainstem nuclei, vestibulospinal, reticulospinal. From the reticular formation, there are two tracks, one coming from the pons, the reticular formation of the pons called pontine reticulospinal, and another one coming from the reticular formation of the medulla. The pontine reticulospinal supplies the anti-gravity muscle extensor, and it is excitatory to the extensors. The medullary reticulospinal, it inhibits the anti, so both they are antagonistic to each other, This is the spinal brainstem areas, here. These are the vestibular nuclei, okay? This is the superior here, medial, and inferior and lateral nuclei. So we have four vestibular nuclei here. We have the reticular formation here, the reticular formation. You have the medullary reticular formation and the pontine reticular formation. From where descending tracks, pontine reticulospinal, and these are the tectum, superior and inferior colloculi of the midbrain. Okay. Okay. Now, from the pons, from the pontine reticular formation, it tracks descends down through the medial part, medial column of the spinal cord. It's called pontine reticulospinal. Look to the pontine reticulospinal is intrinsically active. So the pontine reticulospinal has very high basal signals always. So it has very high degree of natural excitability. So the pontine reticulospinal goes, supplies the extensors and causes excitability, causes contraction of the extensors. And this is why we have balance or equilibrium. Now, this pontine reticulospine is always opposed by the medullary reticulospinal. But the medullary reticulospinal is not intrinsically active. The medullary reticulospinal is activated by the cortex, by the motor cortex. When the motor cortex sends its descending tract, which is the corticospinal, when it's going down, it goes to the medullary reticular formation and it causes activation of the medullary reticular formation or reticular formation of the medulla. And these nuclei in the medulla goes and inhibit the pontine reticular formation. Medullary pontine reticular nuclei. So the pontine reticular nuclei is always inhibited by the medullary, but the medullary receives its excitability, its initiation, its impulse, its signal from the cerebral cortex. Now, if there is a cut between the cortex and brainstem. Say there is a disease, there is a damage, there is a cerebrovascular accident that cuts the connection between the cortex and the brainstem. In that case, the medullary in its nuclei, they don't have the activity, they don't have the signals from the cortex. In that case, the pontine reticular formation is not opposed, it's not inhibited by the medullary reticular formation. Since the pontine reticular formation is intrinsically active, it goes to the anti-gravity muscle extensors and excite them, cause contraction of the anti-gravity muscle. Contraction of these anti-gravity muscle might cause rigidity of these extensors, rigidity. And this rigidity is called decerebrate rigidity. D للنفي يعني ما في cerebral cortical control over the medulla. So in case of decerebrate rigidity, which means that these extensors, the anti-gravity muscle is extended, they are rigid, they are spastic. This decerebrate rigidity is due to cut of the connection between the cortex and the brainstem reticular formation through the medulla. Okay? So when unopposed, they cause powerful, when this reticular formation, entire reticular spinal is unopposed, they cause powerful excitation of the anti-gravity muscle, and this will cause rigidity. And this rigidity is called decerebrate rigidity, decerebrate rigidity. Okay. So these are the medullary and pontine reticular formation. From the medullary reticular formation, we have the medial reticulospinal, and from the pontine, we have the lateral corticospinal. So vestibular and reticular reticulospinals, vestibular spinal reticulospinal tract descends from the spinal cord to excite or inhibit dashed the anterior motor that control the body axial muscle, the body axial muscles or anti-gravity muscle. The anti-gravity muscle are the extensors and the hip and shoulder girder. Here in terms of the tracts, motor tracts, we can divide them into lateral motor tracts. And you know the lateral motor tracts, they are found in the lateral column of the spinal cord. And usually these are extensor, these are excitatory for the flexor. And these tracts are the lateral corticospinal. You remember the lateral corticospinal lies in the lateral part of the spinal cord. That is the across the tracts. And we have the robrospinal that comes after a while, we will talk about that comes from the red nucleus, and we have the medullary reticulospinal. So medullary reticulospinal is excitatory to the flexor and inhibitor to the extensor. The medial system pathways excites the extensor, which is the pontine reticulospinal, lateral and medial vestibulospinal. That comes from the vestibular nuclei, which we will come after a while talk about them. This is the medullary reticulospinal tract that lies in the lateral aspect of the spinal cord, and these are the medial system pathways that the pontine reticulospinal and vestibulospinal, okay? The medullary reticulospinal transmits an inhibitory signal to the anti-gravity muscle through the medullary reticulospinal. These nuclei, hakena, they receive collateral from the corticospinal tract and robrospinal tract and other motor pathways. Corticomedullary inhibit excites this tract, corticomedullary. This system can activate the inhibitory action of the medullary reticular nuclei and counterbalance, يعني إنه بتعادل, counterbalance the signal from the pontine. If this signal is cut by any means, then we will have decerebrate rigidity, which means rigidity of the extensor, rigidity of the anti-gravity muscle. في هاي الحالة بتشوف الشخص كأنه جالس على التخت وحاني ظهره كلياته لورا هيك وجهه يعني extensors. He is extensing his body anti-axial muscles. Reticulospinal gives the pontine reticulospinal leads hyperactivity of the anti-gravity muscle. Hyperactivity because the pontine reticulospinal is intrinsically active. So in fact, decerebrate rigidity is due to disinhibition of the medullary reticulospinal. Okay. Disinhibition, sorry, of the pontine. The decerebrate rigidity is due to the disinhibition of the pontine reticulospinal. That is usually inhibition coming from the medullary reticulospinal. If it is inhibited, yani mafi inhibition, that's coming from the medullary due to any damage or any disconnection or the connection between the cortex and the medullary here. Reticulospinal is cut, then we choose form of highly decerebrate rigidity. Now we will come to the other tracks, al-hakeinal vestibulospinal. Vestibulospinal origin from the vestibulospinal is the vestibular nuclei. If you remember here, the vestibular nuclei, here is the vestibular nuclei. We have the hakena in superior. We have the medial. We have the inferior here. And we have the lateral the spine, vestibular nuclei. So we have these vestibular nuclei. Now, these vestibular nuclei, they receive their inputs from the inner ear, vestibular system of the inner ear. You remember when we talked about the auditory system, we talked about the cochlea. Cochlea is the part of the inner ear that is concerned with hearing, audition. And the other part is the vestibule. Vestibule بتكون من اليوتريكل والساكيول semicircular canal. There are three semicircular canals. These are called the vestibular apparatus in the inner ear. So you remember the eighth cranial nerve is called vestibulocochlear. It brings the information from the cochlea, which is hearing, and it brings the information from the vestibule, which is that is due, that's concerned with equilibrium and balance. So the vestibular apparatus system of Boney and Chambers, and the same. If you remember when we talked about the cochlea, we have three scalas here, and we in the middle we have scala media, and in the lateral scala vestibular scala tympani, we have in both scala zone we have perilymph, say extracellular fluid, or endolymph, like the intracellular fluid. Uterus saccule, this is the utricle and saccule, here the saccule, and this is the utricle, and the receptor, the receptors in the utricle and saccule here are called maculae, jama macula, maculae, these are the maculae, okay, these are the maculae. These are the maculae that lies in the utricle and saccule, and these maculae are responsible for linear acceleration. يعني الواحد بيمشي لقدام أو لورا. Linear acceleration. إلى الأمام أو إلى الوراء. ماشي. هذا this is called linear acceleration. Okay, so this is the utricle and saccule are sensory organs detecting the orientation of the head in respect to the linear acceleration. And these areas or these receptors are called maculae, جمع macula. Each of them is macula. فالmacula نفس الحكي لما حكيناه عن الـ organ of Corti هناك. سواء الماكيولا أو اللي في اللي موجودين هي الريسبتورز that are found in the semicircular. We have three semicircular canal in each ear. We have lateral. فاللاترال لما الواحد يقدم قدام 45 درجة اللاترال سيمي سيركولار كانالز بتكون بموازاه الايرث يعني هوريزونتال. فمرات اللاترال وي كول ات اما هوريزونتال او وي كول ات ترانسفيرس سيمي سيركولار كانال. وي هاف انذر كانالز كولد انتيريور. الانتيريور ماشي. شوف هدول الثري سيمي سيركولار كانالز عاملين زي زي بلينز، يعني مش اكس وواي، اكس وواي وزي. فالانتيريور رايت والبوستيريور ليفت في نفس البلين، انتيريور رايت والبوستيريور ليفت في نفس البلين، والانتيريور ليفت والبوستيريور رايت في نفس البلين. هذول البلينز اللي هم in this semicircular canal also. In this semicircular canal we have receptors. هاي receptors كل في بداية كل semicircular canal في receptors. We call them cresta ambularis. Cresta ambularis. This is the cresta ambularis. سواء الريسبتور تبعون الماكيولي أو تبعون الكريستا أمبيولاريس. والكريستا أمبيولاريس الموجودين بالسيمي سيركولار كانالز they are concerned with angular accelerated rotational. يعني الواحد بلف زي هاي الألعاب اللي بنشوفها بتطلع فيها وبتضل تلف فوق زي الدولاب بتضل تلف. هاي بتسوي لك angular acceleration. أو اللي بتلف بكمان نفس الشيء بتلف، إذا بدك تاخذها بتلف لاترالي كمان بتسوي angular acceleration. فذيس از كلياتهم سواء الشوف سواء تبعت الاير، الاير تبعت الاير هناك السوري تبعت الهيرينج بنسميها organ of Corti. الاورجان اوف كورتي شو بتكون؟ بتكون من هير سيلز انر اوتر. نفس الشيء هون بتكون من هير سيلز. هاي ذيس ار هير سيلز. So these are hair cells. They are supplied by vestibular nuclei. These are hair cells. Okay. يعني في cells لها hairs، لها stereocilia ولها kinocilia، واحدة كبيرة والجنبهم صغار. The hair cells هناك عليهم كان في the hearing if you remember كان اسمه فوق the hair cells في membrane proteinaceous protein تقيلة شوية فوق the hairs. وكان the hairs إما أو بتقرب على التكتوريال ميمبرين وبتصير سكراتش. فهذه receptors are stretch receptors. They are mechanical receptors. نفس الشيء هدول الهير سيلز زي ما احنا شايفين هاي الهيرز كمان فوقهم ميمبرين. الميمبرين هون بتكون من كالسيوم كربونات كريستالز اسمه اوتوليثيك اوتوير ليثيك زي الحجارة. Autolithic membrane and this is the هدول اسمهم statoconia. شوف هدول بيكونوا شوية اشي تقيل فوق الهيرز. فالهيرز هاي الماكولي موجودة هون هايها في اليوتركل والساكيول. وهون في جواها في ايش؟ في الاندولينف اللي حواليها. فتلاقي هدول الفستيبولار سيستم او الانر اير ملزقين بالراس. فإن لما أنت تحرك رأسك إلى الأمام so when you move your head to the anterior or posterior شوف الـ acceleration of the head is not the same like the acceleration of the fluid. فالسائل اللي داخل الـ inner ear وأنت بتحرك رأسك بتحركش بنفس سرعة الرأس، بتحرك بسرعة أقل بعدين بيلحق بالسرعة. فعشان هيك because it moves you when you move your head anterior هاي ال hair it moves posterior. ف it excites these hairs. It excites these hairs. If these hairs are excited they will send signals through the vestibular nerve from the vestibular nerve to the vestibular nuclei and from the vestibular nuclei downward fiber vestibulospinals that cause movement of the extensor anti-gravity muscle أو muscle that are concerned with posture or equilibrium. بتعدل الوضع بتاعك بحيث انك ما توقع. اوكي. فاذا هدول هم للماكيولي الستاتوكونيا. اذا these are statoconia. شوف هدول الهير سيلز اللي محطوطين بالماكيولي they are arranged in all areas. يعني أي حركة إلى الأمام وإلى الخلف بأي زاوية راح تسبب إنه movement of certain hairs in that direction or movement of certain hairs in the other direction. وتشوف إنه ال two ears, the ear ال right وال left اللي رايحين على vestibular nuclei بدهم يصير في بينهم stereo synchrony. Synchrony يعني إنه زي الموسيقى يكون متناسقين بحيث في الحركة. إذا هون بالليفت أو الرايت بده يقع الليفت بده الرايت بصير في contraction of certain muscles so to support yourself. نفس الشيء بالangular acceleration. إذا الواحد بصير يدور يلف ماشي إذا بصير يلف هيك في أي اتجاه. شوف هون ال crista ambularis they are found in the three planes with two ears. They are arranged in all directions so as movement, rotational movement in any direction will excite certain also certain cells and inhibit other cells. وهدول لما يروحوا على vestibular nuclei يروحوا على skeletal muscle then they will excite muscles so to support yourself and inhibit muscles that are not needed. These are نفس الشيء. These are hair cells. وهون في كمان بروتيناشيوس ستراكشر اسمه كوبيولا. This is the copula هون. فهدول الهيرز مغروزين في الكوبيولا والكوبيولا نفس الشيء بروتيناشيوس ممبرين. فلما ال نفس الشيء الواحد يسوي انجولار اكسلريشن you move your head in this direction بعدين بي ال fluid it moves in the other direction. It moves in the other direction بهذا الاتجاه. It will excite these cells. These cells are excited, supplied by the vestibular neurons of the vestibular cochlea. روح على the vestibular nuclei and it causes movement in one of the directions, other directions, right or left, so as to support yourself. Okay. طيب. لو قلنا إنه أنت بدك تلف هدول. شوف هاي الدولاب هذا اللي باخده او سواء هوريزونتال ولا هون فوق بتعلى فوق بتلف لف دائري. في بداية اللفة at the beginning of rotational movement you think that يعني you feel that you are feeling بدك توقع بدك تصدف. ليش؟ لأنه the fluid that is found inside your ear inner ear is not moving at the same speed of your head. It lags. Action is this. You move faster, your head moves faster than the fluid. فال fluid بحرك الكوبيولا backwards. انت move you forwards. بتشعر انك بدك توقع بتعدل حالك. بعد شوي if the rotational movement is fixed يعني صرت تمشي بنفس the speed. بعد شوي after a while the fluid and the head will move in the same speed. If they move in the same speed there is no more excitation of the hair cells. فال hair cells بصير لما أروح ما في excitation بقى كل نفس ال fluid في نفس الحركة. امتى when you start feeling that you are rotating امتى بتشعر انك you are rotating when you stop. When you stop شو بتصير السرعة zero بس ال fluid ما بوقف على zero طوالي بصير له deceleration. هناك كان في البداية acceleration تسارع هون deceleration تباطؤ بصير له تباطؤ تشعر انك بدك توقع بتعدل حالك بالاتجاه. So you support yourself in the other direction you don't fall down. اذا كان كل شيء تمام. After a while صرت انت سرعة الفلويد zero زي سرعة البادي. You don't feel that you are rotating. So this is what we will do what we'll have. So this is the maculae. Look to the maculae here. They are supplied by efferent and afferent neurons. وحكينا ال efferent, if you remember, the efferents here are very important for corticofugal. Cortico, يعني من cortex backwards, ليش? To control the sensitivity. وهذا ال efferent that it transmits the impulses. وهي هون زي ما احنا شايفين الستوتوكونيا او الاوتوليثيك ميمبرين. والاوتوليثيك ميمبرين از كالسيوم كربونيت فوق الهير. فوين يو موف فورورد هير الستيوتوكونيا moves backward. هاي هون شوف هون you move your head anteriorly. شو اللي صار؟ you move هيك ال head بصير they move on the other direction. On the other direction. So this force the gravity here. This is the autolithic. Autolithic يعني calcium carbonate crystal عشان تسوي وزن هون تضغط على ال هون. هون ال hairs اللي لهم كاليا واحدة كبيرة واللي جنبهم stereocilia صغار. هلا movement of the stereocilia باتجاه الكاينوسيليا بتعمل depolarization. Movement of the stereocilia away from the kinocilia يعني هدول الستيريوسيليا الصغار. اوكي الصغار الستيريوسيليا الصغار هدول. If they move toward the kinocilia هاي الكبيرة إذا move هيك بصير depolarization of the cell بصير release of the neurotransmitter. If these they move away from the kinocilia هاي الطويلة then they will have repolarization. زي ما احنا شايفين this is the hair cells they are supplied by efferent and by afferent. By efferent, efferent هون الريد والافرنت البلو. افرنت بلو. This is the macula that is found in the macula in the utricle and saccule. والماكولا هاي they are concerned with linear acceleration. Linear acceleration. شوف كيف مشي هيك head back and forth. تصير الموفمنت هيك. Now also the cresta ambularis that is found where? In the semicircular canal. شوف هون semicircular canals. هاي هون فيها ال كريستا امبيولاريس وهون الممبرين نفس الشيء بروتينيشس ممبرين اسمه كوبيولا نفس الشيء فيها ستيريوسيليا وكاينوسيليا نفس الشيء the same thing supplied by afferent and efferent. والافرنت حكينا وظيفته to maintain excitability of these cells عشان تظل excitable to control their sensitivity. شوف هاي الموفمنت شوف هاي الصبية بتلف هيك راسها تلف راسها هيك كل ما تلف راسها في اتجاه مثلا لفت براسها هيك الكوبيولا ما بتمشي بالاتجاه بتمشي بالبداية بالاتجاه المعاكس بعدين تمشي باتجاهها بعد بصير السرعة نفس الشيء فهدول they will excite these fibers sensory وthen coming from لما توصل فوق للكورتكس ترجع كورتيكو fugal fibers بتعدل the sensitivity of these cells. Okay, so this is the cresta ambularis. Cresta ambularis. This is macula حكينا statoconia autolithic membrane. This is the hair cells. The statoconia makes the structure too top heavy عشان تقله شوي so that it is capable of responding to changes in head position. Gravity sensitive receptor consists of gravity sensitive hair cells, adult hair cells in the macula. This is the hair cells. All hair cells حكينا إلهم kinocilia هاي الكبيرة دول stereocilia. When the stereocilia moves toward the kinocilia, بصير depolarization. When the stereocilia moves away from the kinocilia, there is hyperpolarization. Then bending in one direction causes depolarization, bending in the opposite direction causes hyperpolarization. Have a series of protrusions and one large. These structures are directionally sensitive. Directionally sensitive, yani they are sensitive to the change in direction. Change in direction. Okay. طيب, detection of head orientation. In each macula, حكينا, there are different hair cells that are oriented in different directions. كل directions they are detected في hair cells. Some are stimulated when the head bends forward, some when the head bends backward, and some when the head moves to the sides. هذا a linear acceleration. The patterns of excitation of hair cells apprises the brain. يعني بصير لما يصير في excitation, they go to the brain stem, vestibular nuclei, from the vestibular nuclei down to the vestibulospinal to correct the position. So the pattern of excitation of hair cells apprises the brain of the orientation with respect to حكينا linear acceleration macula, linear acceleration. The angular acceleration هو تبع الكريستا. This is the cresta ambularis. شوف، when you move your head in one direction, the copula moves in the other direction. بيصير stimulation. When the head movement is stable, after a while, the copula is decelerated. بتاخد الوضع اللي هو resting. بيصير there is no more stimulation. This is called adaptation. We will come to adaptation after a while. السيميسيركلر كانال اور لوكيتد 90 ديجريز تو ايتش اذر. حكينا البلين اللي هو اكس واي زي بلين، فهذا اللي هو مثلا this is the anterior right, they are in the same plane of the posterior left, the anterior left in the same plane of the posterior right. The others, horizontal, واحدة من هون، واحدة من هون. If you move your head 45 degrees, بكون ال horizontal على مستوى الأرض. These are called horizontal or lateral semicircular canal. All located 90 degrees to each other, represent three planes in lateral or horizontal. هدول ال horizontal or lateral, transverse. وفي anterior وفي posterior. Each duct has an enlargement called ampullae, ampullae crista ambularis. Within the ampullae there is sensory called the crista ambularis, has sensory receptors. These are receptors for angular acceleration. Bending the crista ambularis in particular excites hair cells. Hair cells excited, hair cells inhibited. It goes maintaining equilibrium. Information from the hair cells in the maculae and uterus is transmitted via vestibular nerve, and also information from the crista ambularis, they are transmitted through the vestibular nerve. When the body is accelerated forward, the hair cells in the maculae bends in the opposite direction. This causes one to feel as if they are falling backwards. هذا اللي بيحصل لو احنا فرضا احنا ماشيين في الباص، بدنا ننزل في الباص وهو ماشي شوية بسرعة خفيفة. طبعا احنا ما ننزل نطلع قدامنا هيك، لو طلعنا قدامنا بصير بدنا نوقف على سبيد زيرو، بس الفلويد اللي في اذننا الداخلي ما بيمشي اصلا واحنا ماشيين بالباص. الفلويد اللي باذننا بيمشي بنفس سرعة الباص، بنفس السرعة اللي احنا ماشيين فيها. فلما نوقف على زيرو الفلويد بيرجع لورا، لسه ما مشي بنفس السرعة. إذا ماشي it will excite the cells and you will feel that as you are going to feel to fall backwards. بدك تدب لورا، بدك توقع لورا. فأنت عشان ما توقع من الباص وأنت نازل، أنت بتحاول تنزل باتجاه وهو ماشي، وبتسوي ديسيليريشن شوي 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 عشان ما توقع. This is why you when you get out of a bus when the bus is moving you go forward مع الباص عشان تعمل decelerate. إذا ما عملت if you don't decelerate مع الباص شوي شوي you're going to fall backwards. ليش؟ لأنه the fluid in your inner ear still is moving faster than you are. ما عملوا الـ initial deceleration تبعه، التباطؤ تبع الفلويد مش نفس تباطؤ الشخص لما يوقف لزيرو. اوكي، ف reflexes causes the body to lean forward. فبدك انت reflexly بدك تتقدم لامام خوف لانك تقع لورا. اوكي طيب، semicircular ducts. Semicircular duct rotation of the duct detects rotational movement of the head, rotational acceleration. حكينا الـ endolymph tends to remain stationary in the duct because of inertia. Rotation of duct in one direction causes relative movement endolymph in the opposite direction. نفس الحكاية، انت امتى بتشعر انك بتلف؟ When you feel that you are rotating, at the beginning of rotation and at the end of rotation. At the beginning بديت، when you accelerate بتوصل لسبيد، when you reach certain speed ال ماكيولي سوري سيمي سيركولر كانال الكريستي امبولاريس الهير تبعها مع الكوبيولا بتعاود ترجع شوي 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 للسبيد. هلا صارت تمشي نفس السبيد تبعت الهيد it, when it goes to the same speed of the head there is no more stimulation of these maculae. You don't feel that you are rotating. Then when you feel you are feeling that you are rotating at the beginning of rotation and at the end of rotation. At the beginning, because the head, the fluid is not accelerating at the same speed of the head. At the end, because the fluid is not decelerating at the same speed of your body. So stop the rotation, the opposite happens. When rotation of the in one direction causes relative movement of the endolymph in the opposite direction, activating the receptors of the crista. Stop direction command, you feel that the opposite happens. طيب هون بنحكي عن الادابتيشن اوف ذا هير سيلز سواء الهير سيلز تبعت اللينير اكسلريشن او الهير سيلز اوف ذا انجولار اكسلريشن. شوف الادابتيشن. اول شيء ذيس هير سيلز ذي هاف فيري هاي ريت اوف بيزل ديسشارج فيري هاي ريت اوف بيزل ديسشارج يعني عندهم دائما اكسايتابيليتي. Remember, basal discharge, عم نحكي عنه حكينا عنه في other areas. حكينا البيزل discharge لما حكينا عنه في الهيرينج. The hair cells, حكينا إلها basal discharge. حكينا البيزل discharge is important for positive and negative control. لأنه لو كان ما في discharge, بالsensory system حكينا كمان. لو كان ما في discharge, بالmuscle spindle حكينا. لو ما في discharge, الdischarge تبعها zero. طب how we can go beyond zero؟ كيف نقول والله ما في impulse بالمرة؟ impulse صارت ناقص 50 ما بصير. بس لو impulse rate normally at rest is 100, you can go below 100 ولا صار zero ممكن. 100 صار 200, 300 بدك إياه. بس ما بيصير تقولي والله كان zero ممكن كان zero صار 200 بس كان zero صار كم؟ L minus here. Then this basal discharge here is very important. It can give you good negative and positive control. هلا بدينا rotation. You start rotating. What happens? The discharge rate of these hair cells increases. شوف rotation continues. هلا الهير سيلز after a while starts to have the same speed of the head. فشو بيصير؟ بيصير ال number of discharge decreases until you come where? To the resting state. To the resting state. ماشي؟ إذا هون this area here although you are rotating تفرج هون you are rotating but you don't feel that you are rotating. Why? Because the discharge here discharge rate is the same discharge rate by the way although they are rotating. Please start the speed of the fluid in your head is the same the speed like in your head. So this is adaptation. This is adaptation. Now when you stop rotating the impulse rate goes down. بعدين the impulse rate starts to ترتفع ترتفع after a while although you stopping رجعت للنورمال. رجعت للنورمال. Okay. And this is very important for the circular canal. How fast you are rotating في البداية it gives you a discharge rate that is related to the speed of rotation. Speed of acceleration. If the speed of acceleration is faster the increase in the impulse rate is more. If the speed of acceleration is slower يعني ممكن أنا أوصل بدي أمشي بسرعة 5 كيلومتر في الساعة ممكن اوصل 5 كيلومتر في الساعه في دقيقتين ممكن في 5 دقائق ممكن في دقيقه اذا كان في دقيقه الاكسلريشن هاي بتعطي بتخلي ذا سيمي سيركولار كانال سيل ذا كريستا امبيولاريس سيلز الديسشارج فاستر ذان وين اي ريتش ذا سبيد 5 مثلا كيلومتر بير اور ان 2 مينتس او ان 5 مينتس او شيء. سو ذيس از امبورتنت ذات ذيس سيلز ذي ريسبوند تو ذا ريت اوف acceleration, rate of change. شو يعني rate? The speed. السرعة.
إذا هاي الخلايا these cells will tell you what is your speed of change. طيب نتذكر هاي وين كانت مهمة؟ كانت مهمة في المصل سبندل. لما حكينا على المصل سبندل it has two reactions, في dynamic وفي static. static يعني في change in the length or بالنسبة للمصل سبندل or the muscle in the Golgi tendon there is a change in the tension. بس the speed of change is very important. rate of change it also tells these muscle spindle here it tells these areas that oh the change is faster is slower is much faster whatever. so this is very important for what for prediction يعني إنه تتوقع إمتى your position will be ahead of time. تتوقع وين ال position تبعك وين بوشن بكون قبل بعد 5 دقائق 10 دقائق 5 دقائق. وهذا الأساس إنك بتقدر توقف عند ال distance اللي أنت بتوالي. okay so the semicircular canal predicts then predicts the situation in which the equilibrium will be affected and this information sent train. فال prediction is very important. if you predict إذا بتعرف إمتى البوزيشن تبعك بكون بعد your body will react and you will correct yourself so you don't fall down or whatever. then corrective measures are initiated before equilibrium is affected. ليش؟ لأنه هون في ال prediction function. neck proprioceptors, neck receptors for position and visual input are contribute to the maintenance of equilibrium. لأن أنت لما تطلع هيك بتشوف عيونك بتشوف المسافة بتشوف السرعة بتتعاون. وهاي إن بتدلك على إنه طب لما بتشوف لما بدك أنت تتحرك من وين هدول كيف بده يصير في اتصال بين الأوكيلوموتور نيرف باتصال بين الأوكيلوموتور نيرف والفيستيبيولار نيوكلياي. هلا بنشوفهم كيف الاتصال هذا. اوكي اذا اول شيء هاي الفيستيبيولار نيوكلياي كلياتهم في اتصال بينهم بين السيريبيلم. لما نيجي عليهم في فيستيبيولو سيريبيلر هناك في فيستيبيولو سيريبيلر في منهم فيستيبيولو سباينلز فيستيبيولو سباينل اوكي غير ريتيكولو سباينل. وكمان عنا بيجي من الكورتيكو سباينال فيستيبيولار نيوكليا فيستيبيولار نيوكليا بتروح على السيريبيلم. والسيريبيلم از فيري امبورتنت وخاصه على الفاستيجيال نيوكليس اوف السيريبيلم فاستيجيال نيوكليس ذات از كونسيرند وذ بالانس اللي هو بارت اوف ذا فيرمس. لما نيجي المره الجاي ان شاء الله بنحكي عن فاستيجيال ريتيكولار تراكت وفي اتصال بينه وبين الريتيكولار فوق الريدي نيوكليوس اللي هو الميد برين. راح نحكي عن الريدي نيوكليوس افتر وايل. خلينا نرجع هون نشوف الفيستيبيولار نيوكلياي. الفيستيبيولار اذا الفيستيبيولار نيوكلياي ريسيفز ذير انبوتس فروم ذا سيمي سيركولار كانال نون يوتريكل اند سكيول. they go where they go to the vestibular nuclei. ما في داعي ندخل في التفاصيل. it goes to the dorsal ولا medial ولا inferior ولا lateral nuclei. and from these vestibular nuclei fibers they go and go and they lead to lateral and medial vestibular lateral and medial vestibular spinal tract medial and lateral vestibular spinal tract. okay and the lateral and medial vestibular spinal tract they correct they supply the extensors or anti-gravity muscle to correct our position. رح هون نشوف العلاقة بين الأوكيولوموتور تراك these are the أوكيولوموتور نيوكليا والفستيبولار نيوكلياي. فإذا هون ممكن يكون abnormality في الفستيبولار نيوكلياي تؤدي لنا إلى abnormality في movement of the eye في movement of the eye. وهون إذا بنتذكر أو ما حكينا لسه على السيريبيلم ممكن يكون abnormality of the eye movement. نشعر إنه the eye is going as if it is dancing. بنسميه tibular nystagmus. Nystagmus is the tremor, tremor of the eye, tremor of the eye. Vestibular nystagmus, شوف from medial longitudinal fasciculus, the connection between the oculomotor nuclei and the vestibular nuclei. Vestibular nuclei. شوف هون من الساكيول واليوتريكل. It goes to the inferior and lateral vestibular nuclei. مش مهم التفاصيل بس at least من اليوتريكل الفستيبيولار بيجيها من اليوتريكل والساكيول وبيجيها من الأمبيولا اللي هي السيمي سيركولار كانال. ومن هناك it reacts and it gives us the vestibular spinal tracts. هلا نيجي للأذر تراك that is also a function of the brainstem. The brainstem بنعرف بتكون من المظلة والبونس والميدبرين. In the midbrain there is a nucleus called red nucleus. Red nucleus. A tract that comes from the red nucleus is called robro spinal. Robro. باللاتيني robro زي روج. Red. فsubstantial inputs come from the motor cortex. فcortico robral fiber. من الموتور كورتكس تيجي للريد نيوكليوس. من الريد نيوكليوس down to the spinal cord as robro spinal. Robro spinal is a crossed pathway. Crossed pathway. Then primary cortex fiber. Synapse in the lower portion of the radionucleus, whatever magnum cellular portion, which contain, شوف هون لما نحكي مثلا عن الريفورميشن نحكي عن الريدينوكليوس نحكي عن vestibular nuclei. Our muscles of the body are represented هناك. يعني لما تحكي بدنا نحرك مثلا الترايسبس بدنا نحرك الاكستنسورز اللي هي كوادريسبس فيموريس whatever. بيجي من السيريبرال كورت the area that represents the quadriceps to the area that represents the quadriceps على الreticular formation to the area that represents the quadriceps على vestibular nuclei نفس الarea our body is represented. شفنا representation في spinal cord في الاكستنسورز وكيف كأنه هذا الشخص حاط عضلات وهيك ايديه وين في الانتيريور في الانتيريور كولوم. وشفنا هون نفس الشيء في الريد نيوكليس كمان our body our muscles of our body muscles of the body is represented in the red nucleus. When it comes from the primary motor cortex from one area مثلا من هذا المصل تبع كذا الاكستنسور هون الريد نيوكليس is concerned with flexors not extensors. It comes it goes to the same area that represents that some that same muscles. ففي عنا magnocellular portion that gives the robrospinal. Magnocellular has somatotopic organization similar somatotopic هون بنحكي عن ال representation of the primary cortex كمان في the red nucleus. Red nucleus and robrospinal. Stimulation of the red nucleus causes relative fine movements of the red nucleus, the robrospinal. The corticospinal supplies the fine muscles of the distal muscles of the hands, يعني fingers, muscles of the tongue talking. These are precise movement of these are supplied by corticospinal. The robrospinal supplies the large flexor, large flexors, the flexors of the wrist, يعني الرسو, or the flexors of the elbow. For the large flexor are controlled by the red nucleus, robrospinal. The distal muscles, they are supplied by the corticospinal. And stimulation of the red nucleus causes relative fine movements, but not as discrete as the primary motor cortex. Control of movements, large flexors, unlike corticospinal that call distal muscles flexor. Accessory route of transmission discrete signals from the motor cortex. يعني التنين سواء الروبروسباينال والكورتيكوسباينال they associate each other. يعني ما واحد مثلا بده يكتب بكتب الكورتيكوسباينال هي ديستال ماسلز بس بده يثبت الرسو. فإف ذا روبروسباينال is destroyed movement of the wrist or movement of the elbow is abnormal. This is a large flexor. But if the corticospinal is destroyed movement of the distal muscle بطل يعرف يكتب بطل يعرف يطبع ماشي. Accessory discrete. طب هون الريبروسباينال شوف الموتور كورتكس
بتودي ل ريدي نيوكليوس هير، وريدي نيوكليوس من الفايبرز بروحوا للروبرو سباينال لللارج فلكسز. من اي اريا هون؟ شوف من الاريا مثلا اوف ذا هاند للاريا اوف ذا هاند ان ذا هير، نفس الاريا فروم ذا موتور كورتيكال اريا تو ذا سيم موتور اريا. يعني هون في representation of our body، هون في representation of our body، في الريتيكولار فورميشن في representation of our body، في الفيستيبيولار نيوكليي في وهلو مجر. اوكي، this is the corticorobro. so red nucleus بتكون جايها من السيريبرال كورتكس. and thank you again. stop.